pod groups are used to join multiple users together to easily manage inbound calls. When calls are received, they are automatically distributed in a ring order of your choice. Round robin, longest idle, ring all, or sequentially. If there are no agents available, the call will be routed to voicemail after your specified timeout, and email notifications will be sent out to any addresses listed. To access hunt groups,
log into your control panel and click the icon for UNIVERGE BLUE Connect. Alternatively, you can access Connect from anywhere on the control panel by clicking Services, then clicking Connect.
Next, click on the Groups tab from the left navigation. To the right, you will see a list of your current groups. To create a new hunt group, click on the Create Group button. On the pop-up creation window, select Hunt Group and click the Proceed button. Set up your hunt group by assigning a name, an extension number, and adding an email address for voicemail notifications. Finally, select the ringing order you would like to occur when calls arrive. You have the options of round robin, sequential, longest idle, and ring all. Click on Create Hunt Group to continue. This will create the hunt group with the initial settings you've applied and automatically direct you to the management window of your new group. To assign a phone number directly to your hunt group, click Assign Phone Number. On the pop-up window, you will see a list of available numbers on your account. Select a number and click Assign. If there are any applicable fees or charges, you will be notified and must confirm the charges on the Totals pop-up window. Your number will be added to the hunt group and shown in the General section. You can delete this number by clicking the red X next to the number and can reassign a new number whenever you wish. The Notifications tab allows you to configure some additional preferences for your notifications. You will see the link Email Notification Enabled. This is because we've already added a notification email to the group. Click this link to access your preferences. Here, you can disable or enable the email notification, include a voicemail transcription, choose to include the voicemail audio file with notifications, and choose to delete the voicemail once the notification is sent. You can also select SMS and enter a cell phone number to receive an SMS text notification. Finally, you can mark voicemails as read after the notification is sent. This automatically assigns the voicemail to the saved box when dialing into the group voicemail. New call recordings can also generate notifications to email. Click on Not Set Up under Call Recording. Next, click on the email checkbox and enter an email address in the field below. When complete, click Save Changes. On the Notifications tab, you will now see Email Notification Enabled next to Call Recording. Menu options are used for alternate call routing destinations, which can be accessed by the caller when they enter the group or while they're holding for an answer. The buttons listed reference the number to be pressed on a phone dial pad. Click Action next to a button you'd like to configure. In the pop-up window, we can set the Move Call To field to one of several options. In this example, we will set the button to Voicemail, Current Hunt Group, and click Save Changes. Once saved, we will return to the Menu Options window and can see our button has changed to signify our new action. Since we are sending the caller to the voicemail of this group, the notification email address of the group is displayed to the right. The next tab in our group management window is Greetings. Greetings are a great way to convey information to a new or currently holding caller. The call flow example at the top gives you a visual representation of when each of the greeting types are played through the group caller's lifecycle. You can add or change a greeting by clicking the hyperlink under the greeting type. greetings you have already uploaded will show in the drop-down menu. You can click Upload New File, select an audio file, and give it an identifying name to store a new greeting file to be used on any greeting type. For this example, we are going to select Initial Greeting, as this was previously uploaded to be used for this type of greeting. Hunt groups must have at least one user or phone number assigned as an agent to properly route calls. Otherwise, callers will only hear your greetings, then be sent to voicemail. On the Agents tab, click Add New Agent to add a user to the group. Select the user by clicking the checkbox to the left, then click the Add button. You will be returned to the agent list, and the user selected will be shown. You can also add an on or off network phone number to the group by clicking Add Phone Number. Enter the full 10-digit number in the text field and click Add. You will be returned to the agent list and see the phone number now showing as an agent. Users can log into the Hunt group by dialing the login code from their device or by logging into My Services and clicking Login. Phone numbers are not able to log in remotely, nor do they have access to the My Services portal, so an admin will need to click Log In for the phone number in this group before they can receive calls. If you have call recording enabled on your Hunt group, all recorded conversations will be listed in the Call Recordings tab. You can fine-tune your date range by clicking the filter option above the list. Simply click the calendar icons to select your dates and click Apply. You can easily play any stored recordings by clicking Play on the recording of your choosing. A pop-up window will appear that contains a media player, as well as an option to forward this recorded conversation or download it directly. You can also click Forward from the list view to forward this specified conversation to an email address. Just enter one or more email addresses separated by a comma or semicolon and click Forward. Metrics are vital to Hunt groups, and all groups have individual call reports that can be accessed from the group management window simply by clicking the Reports tab. You can filter your report by date, selecting either a pre-generated time frame or by setting your own date range and clicking Apply. If you select Today, you are presented with the Active Calls report, showing active or holding calls, agents logged in, and agents currently on Hunt group calls. Upon selecting a pre-generated or custom time frame, you are presented with the Hunt group report. This gives you previous metrics that have been recorded over that time frame, including call statistics, hold time, talk time, and call duration, each with a graph to represent the data visually. You can even edit the service level agreement to suit your company's customer agreements. Under the hold time statistics, click Setup SLA and adjust the first service level field to anywhere between 20 to 1200 seconds. Your first service level is your main goal time that a call will be answered. The second service level is automatically double your first service level, and calls holding into this level may need to be investigated by your staff to ensure agents are meeting your SLAs. Finally, when you're done managing your Hunt group, you can click the Two Groups link at the top left of the page. This will take you back to the groups list, and you should see your new Hunt group configured and ready to go.